The institute was founded by a member of the Wistar family, a very well known, at least in the 19th century, a Philadelphia family who had some wealth. They had several influential members, one of whom was a general during the Civil War, and they had built a substantial library, in addition to which one of the members chose, with enormous foresight, to establish an institute technically called the Wistar Institute of Anatomy and Biology, which had been built in the 1880s and was the first and oldest biological research institute in the United States. It sits in the middle of the University of Pennsylvania campus, and has ties to the university, of course, but it remains independent from the university in respect to management, budget, etc. In order to demonstrate its independence from the institute, from the university, my chief, when I returned many years later, just to give you an idea, a humorous aside, would demonstrate his independence, the independence of the institute from the university. The director at that time was Hilary Koprowski, about whom I'll discuss more later. Hilary would pull out a bottle of whiskey or claret and pour it for a visitor in order to prove that, unlike the University of Pennsylvania, where that is absolutely forbidden and you could probably be sacked for doing it, he was able to do it without fear of any reprisal because it was an independent institute.